given that it's the start of spring, I thought it might be a good time to talk about invasive plants. Did you know that some of our invasive plants are the first to leaf out in the spring season? This can not only help them outcompete our native plants, but it also makes them easier to spot and remove. Today, I thought we could take a quick look at three common invasive plants that are currently leafing out in the seacoast area: Japanese barberry, burning bush, and multiflora rose. So the next plant we're going to take a look at is called burning bush. This plant is known for its bright fall color and is often why a lot of people enjoy planting this in their yard. However, this plant is known to be invasive, and while it's not currently leafing out yet, it has some very distinctive features that make it easy to identify, so I thought we would take a closer look. One of the most distinctive features about this plant is that on the younger stems, which are these greener stems here, they have these quirky wings that develop. This is a very distinctive feature for this plant and makes it easy to identify. The leaves on this plant are also oppositely arranged, and we can see where the buds are for this year's leaves. They're directly across the stem from each other. This plant blooms in May or June, and it has very tiny greenish-yellow flowers that form in the leaf axils. The fruit are fleshy and green capsules that turn red in the fall and are dispersed by birds and other wildlife. Because this plant can tolerate a wide range of light and soil conditions, it outcompetes and displaces native species. Deer also tend to favor native plants over this plant when they're browsing. If you find any of these plants on your property, they can be controlled in a variety of manners. Small, immature plants can be pulled out by hand. Larger plants can be dug out with a garden spade or using a weed wrench or other mechanical means. And herbicide treatments can be used for larger populations of these plants. Monitoring your property for invasive plants can be a productive social distancing activity. For more information on invasive plants, control options, and native plant alternatives, please reach out to us through our info line.